Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
In this video, we are going to determine the acceleration of a projectile motion. Determine the expression of the velocity vector of a projectile. Determine the expression of the position vector of a projectile. And determine the equation of the trajectory of a projectile.
If you throw any object into the air, you observe projectile motion. The cannonball is called projectile. To simplify analysis of the motion of a projectile, we neglect the effects of air resistance. Let's study the projectile motion. In this study, we will consider the object to be launched from the origin of coordinates O at time 0. Look at the figure. An object is thrown in air in the xy plane from the origin O of coordinates with an initial velocity v0, which makes an angle alpha with the positive x direction. Now, the first step in studying the projectile motion is to determine the initial conditions, which are the position vector and the velocity vector of the projectile at time 0. So let's start with the initial position vector. We said that the object is launched from the origin of coordinates at time 0. Then r0 equals 0. Let's move to the initial velocity. The initial velocity has two components, v0x and v0y. Now let's determine the expressions of the components of the velocity. Let's start with v0x. Look at the right-angled triangle formed by v0y, v0x, and v0. Cosine alpha equals v0x over v0, then v0x equals v0 cosine alpha. Now, sine alpha equals v0y over v0, then v0y equals v0 sine alpha. Then, this is the expression of the initial velocity vector of the projectile.
Now, let's determine the acceleration of the projectile. To determine the acceleration, we have to apply Newton's second law. The system is the projectile. The external forces acting on the projectile is only its weight, since we neglect air resistance. Now, in Newton's second law, the net force or the sum of the external forces equals the mass times the acceleration of the projectile. Then mg equals ma. M cancels m. Then the acceleration of the projectile equals the gravitational acceleration g. Since y is oriented positively upward, and g is oriented downward. Therefore, relative to this frame of reference, g equal minus gj, then a equal minus gj relative to this frame of reference. This animation shows the acceleration of a projectile. As we see, the acceleration of the projectile during the ascending and the descending remains minus 10 j.
Now let's determine the expression of the velocity of the projectile. Here we have the expression of the acceleration and the expression of the initial velocity of the projectile. The velocity is the antiderivative or the integral of the acceleration with respect to time. Now, let me remind you with this rule of the antiderivative. If b is constant and y is the antiderivative of b with respect to time, then y equals bt plus y0. Now, y is similar to v, and b is similar to a. Because a is constant, a equals minus gj, minus g is constant, and the unit vector j is a constant vector. Then, v equals minus gj multiplied by t plus v0. Now replace v0 by its expression. You will get this equation, rearrange. This is the expression of the velocity of the projectile. Here is the x component of the velocity and here is the y component.
Focus please. The
This is important.
Let's determine the nature of the motion of the projectile along the horizontal axis and along the vertical axis. This figure shows the velocity and its components of a projectile during ascending, descending, and at the highest position. This figure shows that the motion of a projectile takes place in the vertical plane containing V0. According to the expression of the velocity proved in the previous slide, the x component of the velocity equals V0 cosine alpha, and the y component of the velocity equals V0 sine alpha minus GT. Look at the figure. Since the x component of the velocity remains equal V0x, which is equal to V0 cosine alpha, equals constant, so we can conclude that the nature of the motion of a projectile along the horizontal axis is uniform. Now, let's determine the nature of the motion along the vertical axis. A is constant and always directed vertically downward, and since Y is oriented positively upward, then during the whole motion, A is negative. During ascending, Vy is positive since it is oriented positively upward. So, since Vy is positive and A is negative, then A times Vy is negative. Therefore, during ascending, the nature of the motion is uniformly decelerated. Look at the figure. During descending, Vy is directed vertically downward. So during descending, Vy is negative. Since A times Vy is greater than zero or positive, so the nature of the motion during descending is uniformly accelerated.
This PHET animation shows the X and the Y components of the velocity vector of the projectile. Before starting the animation, I want you to focus on the length and the direction of the X and the Y component vectors. Let's start with the X component vector. It has the same length and direction because the motion is uniform along the X axis. Look at the Y component vector. It is directed vertically upward while ascending, and its length decreases with time because the motion is decelerated in the upward motion. At the maximum height, the Y component vector becomes zero. And in the downward motion, the Y component vector reverses direction and its length increases. Why? Because the motion of the projectile along the Y axis is accelerated in the downward motion.
Let's determine the position vector of the projectile. We know the expression of the velocity vector and the expression of the initial position vector, these two expressions proved before. The position vector is given by the antiderivative of the velocity vector with respect to time. V0 cosine alpha is constant, so the antiderivative of this term with respect to time equals V0 cosine alpha times t. Also, V0 sine alpha is constant, then its antiderivative with respect to time equals V0 sine alpha t. And the antiderivative of g times t equals 1/2 gt squared plus r0, and r0 equals 0. Therefore, the position vector of the projectile is given by this equation. V0 cosine alpha t is the x component of the position vector, and V0 sine alpha t minus 1/2 gt squared is the y component of the position vector. And look at the figure to observe the x component and the y component of the position vector r. This animation shows the position vector of a ball launched with an initial velocity which makes an angle with the horizontal. Now we observe the animation in a slow motion. At this position, x equals 12.7 and y equals 15.15 meters. As we see, x and y vary with time. Now, at this position, y becomes minus 6.54 meters, which is negative, and x equals 35.38 meters.
Let's determine the equation of the trajectory of the projectile. In order to determine the equation of the trajectory, we need to eliminate t between the x and the y components of the position vector. This is the x component and this is the y component. Let's start with the x component. Rearrange. You will get this expression. Now, replace t in the expression of y by the obtained expression. You will get this equation. Rearrange, you will get the equation of the trajectory of the projectile. Now, examine this equation. This equation is of the form y equals ax squared plus bx plus c, where a, b, and c are constants. A equals minus g over 2v0 squared cosine squared alpha, which is constant, and b equals tangent alpha, which is also constant, and c is 0. Then the trajectory of the projectile is a parabola.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.